Hi, this is Karine, your Waalaxy expert. In this video, we'll see how to send your Waalaxy lead data to the CRM of your choice. But before I show you how, I'll give you a quick reminder of why doing it. Whether you're solo or in a team, when you're prospecting, you are usually using a CRM, a place where your prospect's data are updated. Waalaxy allows you to automate your prospecting on LinkedIn and via email, but not only. In itself, Waalaxy allows you to scrape data from LinkedIn members. When you're prospecting, you need to find the contacts of your prospect. So whether you automate your prospecting or not, Waalaxy allows you to 1. Scrape your prospect's data on LinkedIn, and 2. Send the collected information to your CRM, which saves time and avoids human error by entering information. But that's not all. Waalaxy is in partnership with DropContact, so you can scrape your prospect's LinkedIn data, but also request to Waalaxy to retrieve their professional emails, so you can contact them while being fully GDPR compliant. Well, to use this feature, you will need the business subscription. So let's go back to the advanced subscription, which is required to connect to your CRM. Okay, let's get started. If you don't know Waalaxy at all, I strongly advise you to watch our former videos to know what is a campaign and how it works. Okay, now I'm assuming that you know about Waalaxy campaigns. You have two ways to send information to your CRM. It can be through a campaign that includes the CRM sync, in which case the information would be sent as soon as a prospect gets to this step. The other way is available on every campaign. Once your campaign is launched, you can edit it and add the data sending to your CRM when the prospect answers. So Waalaxy will send the information to your CRM only if a prospect in the campaign replies, either by email if your campaign contains emails or via LinkedIn. Oh yes, because as a reminder, if a prospect replies, they will automatically exit the campaign. So we'll be able to connect our CRM. As you can see, we've created shortcuts for some CRMs. We have a native integration with no CRM, and the other CRMs that are offered to you take into account an automation via Zapier, which is an integration tool. To use these shortcuts, you will need a Zapier premium subscription. If you don't want to subscribe to Zapier, you can create your own webhook. This requires some advanced computer skills, but it's possible. You can also use a webhook with another integration tool such as Integromat or N8N. Well, I may have lost you a few seconds ago because maybe you don't know what is a webhook. I won't go into the exact definition of what is a webhook, but rather explain what's going on. Whether you use Zapier or any integration tool, the webhook will be a URL. When the CRM sync step is applied, Waalaxy will send all the information retrieved on each concerned prospect to this URL as a JSON file. From there, Zapier or any other integration tool will retrieve this information and send the information of your choice to the CRM of your choice. Well, let's look at the practice. It will be easier. If you use Zapier and your CRM is not proposed, I advise you to choose the Google Sheet integration. The information will be sent to the Google Sheet thanks to the first Zap, and you will only have to create a second Zap to transfer to your CRM. Be careful, you need two Zaps to do so. We send several leads at the same time on the JSON file, and by using only one Zap to go from the webhook to the Google Sheet to your CRM, the data won't be processed properly. So here, I will select Google Sheet and stop once the data is sent to it. As you can see, we have already pre-filled the Zap. You just need to add some information. First of all, you have to generate your own webhook and then paste it on Waalaxy. Now that it's done, you can save your campaign and the Waalaxy side is finished. And we continue on the Zap. We choose split text since several prospects can be sent at the same time. We choose the information we want to receive. As you can see, the data are separated by semicolons, so we will make sure that each semicolon corresponds to a new box on our Google Sheet. Remember to select all as line items so that the Zap does not keep only the first prospect. And then do the same for all the other data. Of course, if you want to give more or less, you can add or remove steps that format the text. You have to connect to Google account. I advise you to first create the sheet with the different columns for the data you are interested in. Okay, so I connect my account, I choose my sheet, and now I can choose the information I want to retrieve. Okay, now we can run the test to make sure everything is okay. While the test is going on, subscribe to our YouTube channel. You will become a marketing expert thanks to our videos. Okay, we can see that the information is on the sheet. Of course, that was a test, but if the test is conclusive, everything is in place for the real prospects. Just remember to activate your Zap and you're done. If you are connecting to a CRM, I suggest you check our blog to see if we have a tutorial about it. It will really help you as every CRM is different. And there you have it. For your information, each data upload to the webhook counts as a credit on Zapier. To avoid a surplus, we send the leads per bulk as soon as possible. Basically, we send either in batches of 10 or every 30 minutes if we don't have 10 leads. If you have any questions, contact us via the chat on Waalaxy.com. See you soon on Waalaxy.